What's up, guys? It's Mitch again with a little supplement to the ball dip video. Got a couple requests to show the assembly of the Rhino Racing C-LSD, and it just so happens that Ike here at RG has a brand new LSD that he's looking to put into his new Shark, so I thought I'd use this opportunity to show you guys on video how it all goes together. Not only show assembly, but also explain a little bit how the differential works, what adjustments you can make, how they affect the performance of the diff, and advantages of using it for anyone with one already, or for those of you who are looking to get one for yourself. They come in this nice new packaging now, a lot nicer when they just threw all the hardware into the bottom of the can, so I'm gonna lay all the parts out here and we'll get started. Alright, so I have all the parts laid out and organized here. We have the main gear housing, two side covers that are also sold in red and purple for those of you with the red or purple chassis. We have your internal gears and spacers along with the pins for them, hard and soft springs. We have another thrust bearing to assemble, two green O-rings that are to seal the outdrives from any outside dirt or debris, shims for the outdrives, two internal gears, bearings, and two aluminum outdrive cups with the pins to secure them on the drive gears. It looks like a lot of parts, but the build isn't too bad, and I'd say it's worth the effort of putting one together for yourself. We're also going to need a couple types of greases. I'm opting for some of the black grease from the ball diff for the thrust bearing assembly again. This grease also comes standard with YD2 kits to be used for the diff outdrive O-rings and the axles. This would be part number CS-BGA if you need to pick some up. It's also a good idea to grease everything else with some metal on metal grease. If you have the white grease from the ball diff, that could work, but try to spread a thin amount on the gears because that grease can be a bit thick and you don't want a super thick grease packed inside that will affect the openness of the diff off throttle. That's part number CS-DGA. But today I'm opting for some of this HRC Topline Collab metal slime grease that we have in the shop. The version 2 is great for closed gear boxes like the CLSD with a high tackiness that will keep the grease on the parts under high RPMs with a low scatter rate and increase in durability, so this will work great for this application. Other tools you may need are various pliers and tweezers along with a good caliper, and I'll show you why once we get to installing the springs. I think we have everything we need here, so let's get to putting this thing together. So I'm gonna start off with one of the side covers, and this one needs the springs put in before we screw on the main gear. The spring needs to be stretched to a specific range, and this is probably the weirdest thing about this diff assembly you'll come across. The springs need to be stretched around something 7 to 8 millimeters to a 75 to 80 degree angle. So grab your calipers and start measuring stuff around your house or shop or wherever you're building this. I have this Yokomo turnbuckle wrench that comes included with all the YD2 chassis kits that just happens to mic out to about 7.9 diameter. So I'll use this. The soft springs measure out to about 0.15 millimeters. And the hard springs at 0.20 millimeters. The Rhino Racing sheet is a bit vague on the tuning aspects of each configuration, but from what I take from it, the soft springs offer a faster lock and the hard springs offer a later locking of the wheels. Ike wanted a 8-gear soft spring setup to give the fastest and hardest lock to start, so I'm gonna grab the soft springs here and stretch them out around the turnbuckle wrench to what I think is about 75 to 80 degrees. If you're not good at geometry or angles, just go slightly less than 90 degrees or a perfect L shape like this. Just get it close. I'm sure it's fine if it's not dead on. After all those are done, I'll slip two in here to show you. This is what you would want for a 4-gear setup, but since we're doing 8-gear on this LSD, I'm gonna put all 4 springs in. Then the last step is to take one of the bearings and slip it into the cover. Now that our springs are in, we can put the gears in. For a 4-gear setup, we would only use 4 gear sets, obviously, and only the 2 spring setup, but we're doing 8 gear, so we'll need to make 8 gear sets. To do this, we can grab a pin, gear, and spacer, and put them all together. I'm gonna grease everything lightly with the HRC grease as I go. After we have those built, we're just gonna stick the pins into this section in the cover against the spring, alternating which side the gear sits on each time. This is what the four gear setup should look like built. I'm gonna put the rest in for eight gear though. You can see it goes spacer, gear, alternating each hole. And now we can build the thrust bearing. The thrust bearing consists of the two drive gears, center pin, these two washers, and this cage ball bearing assembly that goes in the middle of the washers. We're gonna start by taking one of the drive gears and sticking the pin in the center after lightly greasing it. Now we'll slide a washer onto it. Pay close attention to the direction of the washer. These washers have grooves in them and the grooves will sit in the middle for the balls to seat into, so the flat side will sit against the gear. Now we'll slide the bearing cage over the pin and we can pack a small bit of the black grease into it. Slide the second washer over, groove towards the bearing cage. Bearings on, and that's our thrust bearing assembly. Now we can slide this in the middle of the other gears and onto the side cover, turning it to get the gears meshed up properly. And that's the whole internal assembly done. Before we put the main gear housing over everything, unless you thoroughly grease the gears during assembly, I like to get a thin layer of grease on some of the gears and then turn them to start distributing the grease to all the gears inside. It's pretty hard to grease these without taking it apart once it's all together, so now would be the best time to make sure you have everything greased the way you want it. You can spin the main output shaft to help distribute the grease to all the gears. After that, we can carefully slide the main gear housing over everything and get the screws in on the bottom. If you feel uncomfortable about screws backing out, you can Loctite the cover screws with a bit of blue Loctite. I actually had a couple start to back out once, but honestly, I think I just forgot to snug them down the last time I had my LSD apart for servicing, and I usually don't have problems with screws backing out of my cars. Once the bottom cover is on, we'll take our other cover with the spring and bearing already installed and place it over the top. Try to line everything up and it should go together easy. Don't try to force it on. Just wiggle it around until you get the pins to set in where they need to be. Snug the screws down. grab the green O-rings and slip those over the drive gear stubs. Take the shims, slide those on after the O-rings. Take your outdrive cups, slide those on the stubs. Line up the holes, stick your pins through. And you're done. The 10x15 bearings will hold the pins in once the diff is installed, so if you ever take it out of your car, be careful the pins don't fall out and you lose them. Just spin the outdrive and diff assembly, make sure there's no abnormal crunchiness and everything feels light and smooth and should be ready to go. If it feels a bit tight, try only using one shim on each outdrive or no shims. It looks like they've included a lot more shims since I've got my CLSD, and these might just be for adjustments later on once your diff starts to wear slightly. If you do feel anything binding, try taking the cover and main housing off, spin everything to make sure it's all spinning freely, and put them back on. Now we'll install this on Mike's car and I'll show you the diff in action and explain a bit how it works. So I have the car here on a stand, and you can see if I spin one wheel, it's very free spinning. Almost similar to a no oil, no outdrive O-ring gear diff I used to use, which gave me very good corner stability and predictability without quick over rotations on hard throttle, while possibly lacking some of the forward grip that comes from a more locked diff. But with this CLSD, you can have the best of both worlds. I'm gonna hold one wheel lightly while I give it some light throttle. You can see only one wheel is spinning, like an open diff. The diff is going to act like an open diff on low to mid throttle, so once your car is set in mid corner, it should be very stable with decent traction. Now if I give it a bit more throttle, the diff locks up and makes both wheels spin. This is useful for a corner exit or initiation where you're getting more on the throttle, and it'll lock up both wheels and give you good forward bite and forward speed coming out of the turn, or make your car rotate quicker to set your angle coming into the turn. The spring hardness will determine how fast the diff locks and unlocks, soft for quick lock and hard for slower lock on throttle, and the amount of gears will determine how hard both wheels will lock together. 4 gear for a softer lock and 8 gear for a stronger lock. I hope that helps you out, whether you already have a CLSD or are wondering how it all goes together or are on the fence about grabbing one for your build. It really is an innovative part for these cars up there with the HRC Nerd dampers that we also have started carrying when we can get them. We're really starting to bridge the gap between real cars and RC cars and the amount of tuning that we can do with these. It's pretty wild. I remember hearing about some guys in Japan using an active differential for the X-Ray XB2 off-road buggy in their YD2s before the CLSD was around. That worked in a similar way but with different parts. It was a bit more expensive, but now that the CLSD is here, it's really one of the best drop-in diff options for the YD2, Rhino Max, and the Gulm. As with any of these parts, in my opinion, they all need to work together to suit your driving preference. No one part is going to make you the next greatest driver, and you must tune everything to work together for you. But if you know what you're doing with your car, this might be the next part to push you to the next level of driving. Can't wait to see you push your limits with your CLSD against the best of the RG circuit.